Hey everyone. Well, about 3 weeks ago I did a video with this software here called Keyscape, which is what I've been using lately to do my piano covers and things like that. It's a fantastic plugin, I guess you can call it that. Quite expensive, but I think it's worth it, especially for me. I'll get a lot out of it. Comes with quite a few presets, as you can see. So I thought I'd just go through some of these, select a few, and just randomly play any old song with it. So this is mainly, I guess, somewhat like a bit of a review of the sounds, not necessarily how crappy I'm playing lately. So yeah, and a lot of these songs I haven't played for a long time, but it's just whatever comes into my head at the time. You'll see that it'll come up here, previewing sound, etc. I have to wait till that says it's finished until I can start over again. So yeah, I'll get on with it. Oh, also, on the track here I have a plugin called Sparkverb, and it's by a company called UVI, who I have quite an extensive collection of their stuff as well. It's my go-to reverb plugin, so I've just got that set on a light setting for that track. So anyway, I'll get on with it, and again, this is mainly just to demo and preview the sounds. So it'll probably be a lengthy video, but you know, it is what it is, so I'll give it my best shot. Help if I can get this right first of all. Yeah, that's better. Okay. Nice sounding piano, the C7 Grand, which I demonstrated in the last video I did. Go to the bright one. So once this is loaded, I will start playing. Just means that all the samples in the background have sort of all loaded and are in place and ready to go. Thank you. too bad, a little bit brighter as the title suggests. What else will we look at? Kind of like how these pitches change as well. Just quickly as well, depending on your synth or keyboard, in the settings you can select the velocity curve, which I think is really cool. I had this, I didn't know about this for a long time actually, and then I found it out just by looking around, and I selected the right synth, and sure enough it does make a difference. So just thought I'd add that there. Rich ballad, let's see. Kind of eerie looking graphics there, but it's a bit of a demonstration of what the sound might be like. Thank you. Okay, this one's classical. So I can't play classical piano to save my life, so... Slowly running out of songs to play, sadly. Sometimes forget. It's one of the bad things from learning by ear. You can hear it in your head and you can play it, but every single time that I play something, it's different. So that's one reason why I don't do tutorials, is because I could play it through one way, and then when I go back around to show it again, it'll be different, so people just get too confused. Thank you. So we got next one we'll have a look at is Ballad. Bit of an upright happening. Might take a bit longer for the samples to load because it's an upright. No, a lot quicker actually. Now it seems like I'm skipping a lot, but I'll just go to something a little bit different. Okay. Obviously, that would be so much better with the vocal choir type sounds over the top, but it is what it is. What else have we got here? Clavichord? Taking a long time to load. Probably not my type of instrument, but okay, now these ones are cool. MKS-20, so this is like a Roland rack type synth that came, oh, it's actually a digital piano sort of rack that came out in the 80s, I believe. So, let's have a look here. Electric e-piano. Thank you. Roland JD800, one of the classic synths, used in a lot of dance music sort of songs in the 90s. Amazing instrument. I really hope that Roland Cloud will release this as its own module. What I mean by that is not part of the anthology series, actually like an actual standalone sort of instrument with all the presets would be amazing. Something better with that, but I can't think of any more songs to play, sadly. One of my all-time favorite pianos, the Electric Grand CP70 from Yamaha. This is so famous, this instrument. It was used so extensively through the late 70s and 80s. Very unique sounding song. So Phil Collins used it. That key change. What else? Simple Minds used it. I think there's not much else to really show in this, but let me know what you think. I have heaps more instruments that I'll be going through at a later date, just to give you a bit of an example. Got a bit of a list here of instruments and VSTs that I have. Anyway, we'll leave it there, and I'll do another video soon.